the answer writing class, and this class in the questions that I have uploaded on brainiki.com on 4th of October. Not 4th, 5th of October, 4th of October was Sunday. So, the first question is, discuss how the synergy between the payment banking and cashless economy holds the potential for creating a transparent economy. Now, this question is about payment banking and this question is about cashless economy. Now, payment banking and cashless economy. Now, these two things are related to each other and the synergy between them will help in creating a transparent economy. Now, if you want to take both these aspects synergetically, if you want to view this thing of payment banking and cashless economy as one thing, it will help you in eradicating maladministration, misadministration in rural India. If you will view it synergetically, it will help in making economy transparent for rural India. Now, why rural India? Because this payment banking, it has been introduced by the Reserve Bank of India to venture into the areas where our formal banking sector has failed to. So the venturing of this payment banking is more into the areas where our performance has not been that good. So these payment banking will help the people to join the banks. This payment banking will actually empower the people to be part of the financial economy of India. Now, when they will be the part of the financial economy of the India, now they will be able to receive the benefits of the various policies and programs of India in the form of finances directly in their account. When the amount will directly come in their account, the chances of the amount reaching the unintended beneficiary will not be there. It will directly be reaching the intended beneficiary. Jiske liye paisa hai, usi ke paas jayega. So transparency ho jayegi ki kahan se kis policy ke liye. Agar PDS system work kar raha hai, to kahan pe wo paisa ja raha hai. Agar Swajal Dhara program ka paisa rural India mein ja raha hai, to kahan pe ja raha hai wo paisa. Now, this will help in creating up a transparent economic landscape in administration. This transparent economy means just creating up a transparent landscape in rural India. Then there is another aspect attached to it. Now, if you will just view it, this cashless economy is one thing, then this cashless economy holds a lot of potential. This cashless economy will help in eradicating black money. This cashless economy will help in eradicating money laundering. This cashless economy will help in looking out for the money that is transferred for conducting or doing illegal trades like human trafficking, drug trafficking, and trafficking of the antiques. So all these things can be tracked if we will introduce this cashless economy. Now, 80% of the black money is generated because of the cash transactions. Now, if the economy will be cashless, if the economy will be just card-based economy, if the economy will be just plastic-based economy, then we will be able to track the transactions, and if a transaction will be of a higher value, then the Directorate of Revenue Intelligence can keep its eye, can monitor from where this particular amount has come or where this particular amount is going. Now the students, they have not dichotomized this aspect, they have just dealt it as if both things are correlated to each other. You should have dissected this payment banking individually, and then you should have dissected this aspect individually. This would have made your answer look more better, but most of the students have not done this. Now the second is, how can India empower intelligence agencies and its repercussions on privacy? Most of the students, they have written on this aspect, on empowering intelligence agencies. Now jab aapko pooch hi liya hai usne ki how can India empower intelligence agencies, aapko pucha hai कि आप किस तरह एम्पावर कर सकते हो इंटेलिजेंस एजेंसीज को, और जो भी आप तरीका बताने जा रहे हो उसका क्या प्रभाव पड़ेगा लोगों की प्राइवेसी के ऊपर. नाउ यू कैन बी वेरी इनोवेटिव. नाउ इंटेलिजेंस जस्ट मींस इंटेलिजेंस जस्ट इंटेलिजेंस एजेंसीज फंक्शनिंग जस्ट मींस दैट इट हैज टू कलेक्ट इंटेलिजेंस. नाउ देयर आर एन नंबर ऑफ वेज ऑफ कलेक्टिंग दिस इंटेलिजेंस. वन इज एलिबी, द अदर इज एक्सक्यूज, and the other means are by tapping your phone, the other means are looking up for your information with respect to the financial transactions that you are doing, looking out for your information through the mails that you are sending, through the messages and through the WhatsApp and the other such kind of social media application that you are using. So these intelligence agencies, what they will be trying to do, they will be filtering all the messages. Now how can we empower and strengthen these intelligence agencies? There are n number of ways by which we can strengthen it. We must give them the power to look out for the information. We must give them more and more investigative power so that they can do private investigations, not the formal investigations, informal investigations to look out if something fishy is going on or not. But this could also have repercussions on the private privacy of the people. The people might abhor what the government would be doing, government might be intruding into their personal domain. Then this could be the repercussion. So this was the question, and nobody has written on this, and it's repercussions on private, like your information about your finances could be stolen, about the message that you might be sending to your loved one, that can be stolen. Then the information about where all you are spending the money from, all the money is coming, also the your personal information, the kind of the disease that you are having, then your information about where you would be going, then that information could also be used by somebody who wishes to harm you. There would be private messages, etc. So the privacy should be respected, but we need to balance out between security and privacy. I was expecting this thing in conclusion. Then the third question is like, how can, the third is, critically analyze India's mental health policy. Now one of the girl, Shristi Nistal, she has written a very good answer, but that answer is lacking in content. So what you need to do is just go and just read this national health, mental health policy. Now why this policy has been introduced? Now most of the people, due to the economic pressure, they are facing a lot of mental health problems. They are not able to take stress, and there are certain people who are very much vulnerable to these mental health diseases. Then the sex workers, they are really vulnerable. Then there are children, then there are elder population who is staying away from their children. They are really, really vulnerable to this mental health stress. Then the people who are in poverty. Now the poverty and disease, they make up a vicious circle in which your mental health could go on for a toss. So you, then this mental health policy has taken care of all these vulnerable groups, and this other mental health policy, it is also focused not only on the person but also on the family who is staying with that particular person. And a mental health policy, it is not only for the cure, but it is also focusing on the mental health, the prevention of, just it had focused on to create a better environment for your mental health. It wants to introduce a kind of a syllabus in the primaries and in the secondaries, in the senior secondaries, so that the students can be made aware of the challenges that the mental health people face. And this is something that really needs to be taught in the schools so that the students can face up the pressure. The tendency to suicide, the tendency to harm, the tendency to create flutterings in the society. So this all was required to be mentioned in the answer. Then is plate tectonics unraveled a big mystery. Now mystery, what mystery? The answer should be just like जो क्वेश्चन पूछा जा रहा है उसी के हिसाब से आंसर होना चाहिए. क्या क्या मिस्ट्री है? मिस्ट्री ऑफ माउंटेन बिल्डिंग, ये बताया. मिस्ट्री ऑफ वोल्केनोस कैसे इरप्ट होते हैं, ये बताया. मिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्थक्वेक्स कैसे आ रहे हैं, वो बताया. मिस्ट्री ऑफ प्लेटोस कैसे फॉर्म हो रहे हैं, वो बताया. मिस्ट्री ऑफ जॉर्जेस एंड कैनियंस कैसे बने हुए हैं ओशंस में, वो बताया. मिस्ट्री ऑफ गियोट्स क्या है, वो बताया है. मिस्ट्री ऑफ अंडर वाटर माउंटेन्स कैसे फॉर्म हुई है, वो अनरेवल किया है प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स ने. मिस्ट्री ऑफ व्हाट लाइज बीनीथ द अर्थ क्रस्ट एंड व्हाट इज मूविंग आवर क्रस्ट, ये बताया प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स ने. नाउ दीज ऑल थिंग्स वर डिकोडेड बाय द प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स एंड इट हैज इंप्रूव्ड ऑन द थ्योरी ऑफ कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट थ्योरी and sea floor subtending theory of Harry Hesse. So it was a kind of comprehensive theory that is put forward. The entire crust is divided into major and minor plates, and there is an interaction between these plates that results in forming mountains, volcanoes, earth, rocks, canyons, gorges, and underground water mountains. So such was the flow that was required. So next is, write green revolution criticism. Now most of the students have attempted this question, around 11 to 12 students have attempted this question. Now the criticism of this green revolution, first of all, focus on the human aspect, how it has created disparity in humans. Then focus on the aspect of the food, how it has created disparity in various types of crops. Then focus on the region, how this has created disparity in the regions. And focus on the environment aspect, how the green revolution has led to the excessive use of the pesticides, how the green revolution has led to the exploitation of the water resources, how the green revolution has led to the mass erosion, how the green revolution has caused the parching of the water table. These all points were required in the answer. So this was all for the day. Keep writing answers, because that will help you to improve your answer writing. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.